the Winter 2021 Virtual Music Night. My name is Ricardo Anzaldo, and I'm the Director of Instrumental Music Studies here at Kirby School. While this certainly hasn't been the traditional way we teach or make music, we are excited to bring you what is truly something special. Tonight you'll be seeing performances featuring our wonderful music ensembles, as well as artwork created by some of Kirby's visual art department students. Needless to say, we are so proud of our students' dedication to putting the show together tonight. And we look forward to celebrating the culmination of all their hard work this semester. So get your popcorn and drinks ready. We've got a great show ahead for you.
Good evening, and thank you so much for being with us this evening in this online format once again. If we haven't yet had the chance to meet, my name is Eric Newell, and I'm the new director of choirs at Kirby this year. While the students and I have been completely distanced in our learning and our music making up until this point, and we likely will be for a bit longer, it's still been a joy interacting and singing with students through Zoom and the other formats which we've been able to use so far in this first semester. As is true for the students, I'm sure, I can't wait for us all to be back in this room once again, finding each other in the music that we sing and the words that we sing. And this experience might almost feel somewhat foreign at this point, but it's not lost, and we will have it once again. We can take comfort in that. The choirs hope you enjoy tonight's selections, which center around a theme of a hope for tomorrow, something which we can all identify with in one way or another, I'm sure. Here to introduce the first piece from the combined 8 through 9 and 10 through 12 choirs are Cassidy Orange and Maya Rowan.
I dream a world where man, no other man will scorn, where love will bless the earth and peace its paths adorn. I dream a world where all will know sweet freedom's way, where greed no longer saps the soul, nor avarice blights our day. A world I dream where black or white, whatever race you be, will share the bounties of the earth and every man is free. Where wretchedness will hang its head, and joy, like a pearl, attends the needs of all mankind. Of such I dream my world. I dream a world is sweet, simple, but profound, and remind us of a dream for our future, of equality, peace, and joy. During these tumultuous times, it is especially important to remember this dream and continue to work towards it.
Langston Hughes was a black poet, novelist, and activist who played an important role in the Harlem Renaissance. Throughout his career, which spanned from the 1920s to his death in 1967, he was well known for writing about the experiences of black people in America. Andre Thomas, who set this poem, is a renowned black composer and conductor. I Dream a World, the poem on which this piece was based, was written in the 1920s before the Civil Rights Movement and around the time of the Harlem Renaissance. The dream Hughes writes about likely refers to a world without racism or segregation, which was commonplace at the time. Though this poem was written a century ago, it is still very relevant today. The events of this year have thrown the Black Lives Matter movement into the limelight and shown that even though this poem is 100 years old, it still has a lot of meaning right now.
Such a dream. Hi. For this concert, our orchestra will be playing The Japanese Cricket, composed by John O'Neill. The piece is based on a Japanese folk tune surrounding the tradition of keeping crickets in people's homes as house pets for the enjoyment of their nocturnal singing. Over the course of this semester, our orchestra has explored a variety of folk tunes in cultures and traditions, observing and reflecting on the differences and similarities in instrumentation, performance settings, and cultural contexts. This work is based on the pentatonic scale, which is a scale of five tones. The scale is a major building block in musical arts and lends itself to wind and string instruments that can both produce it with ease. In this musical context, it's meant to paint the singing of the crickets. We hope you also enjoy the paintings from the art department, which are also inspired by the piece. Without further ado, here's The Japanese Cricket.
Of the jazz choir this past semester have really gone the extra mile, still showing up on Zoom at 7:30 in the morning on Wednesdays and Fridays, and being willing to experiment with new ideas in addition to learning solo and ensemble repertoire. Tonight, they'd like to share a classic, A Nightingale Sang in Berkeley Square. This Grammy-winning arrangement of the song, which was made famous by the Manhattan Transfer, famous jazz vocal group, is extraordinarily difficult, and I'm extremely proud of the students for all of the work that they put into learning this and just making this project come together for you tonight. Please enjoy this romantic British standard.
Next to introduce jazz band is Kai Thomas Nassep.
I'm with the Kirby Jazz Ensemble, and we're going to be playing Autumn Leaves. Autumn Leaves was composed in 1945 by Joseph Kosma, and today is one of the most important jazz standards. I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
Here to introduce the final piece for this evening from the combined choirs are Betty Ray and Naima Easter.
The song Hope Lingers On was originally written by Lisa Schneckenberger in 2017 as a song for justice in the folk style. If you were to look up the first performance by the group Lo Luli, you would hear what this folksy version is like. For Lisa, in all of her writing and performances, music means community, according to her biography. This seems to tie into the song as well, as a song of unity and forward social momentum.
Hi. Hope Lingers On is made up of four voices, parts, and percussion. Andrea Ramsey arranged this song to get more and more powerful in a way that is meant to fill you with hope. The song says, I will not hate and I will not fear. In our darkest hour, hope lingers near. We hope you'll find some comfort in this performance. The song reminds me that there is hope. Thank you.
My mother.
Thank you so much for joining us this evening. We hope you've enjoyed the performances and beautiful artwork that our students showcased tonight. Thank you to Tovah Kenton, Katie Trigg, and Elizabeth Neff for all the work you do with our music students, as well as our visual arts faculty involved, including Alex Curzi, Tuesday Soetaert, and Sana Terrell. Thank you also to our recording and video editing intern, Julian Brockenborough. A special thank you to Owen Lindblad, who was kind enough to help me with the countless video editing questions I had in this process, and was also kind enough to film us right now. We would also like to thank Paige Berardo, Jasmine Zamora Garcia, and Evelyn Brown for all your help on the technical end. And a big thank you to our wonderful admin team, Lawrence Shin, Marielle DeRosier, Joe Perot, and Christy Hutton, for all you do for our students. Your tireless dedication to our students does not go unnoticed, especially in times such as these, and we are really grateful to have you. Lastly, parents and families, thank you so much for your support and for letting us turn your living rooms into practice rooms this year. Without your efforts and consistent support, tonight would not be possible. Once again, thank you so much for coming, and have a great night.